as a holiday treat, I am gonna be giving away. I went through my last breakup about. I'm gonna walk you guys through my super easy morning skincare routine. It's literally only 3 steps. I'm testing out the Dr. Dennis Gross Alpha Beta Pore Perfecting Cleansing Gel. I think this is gonna be really good for the morning since it's a gel cleanser and it won't really strip your skin of the natural moistures that kind of form over your face while you're sleeping. All right, we're nice and squeaky clean. You guys know I live and breathe ceramide and cream. Ever since I started using this 2 years ago, I don't get dry, flaky patches anymore. Can't live without it. And I don't even work at Dr. Jart anymore, so you know what's real. And then for the final step, sunscreen. You gotta wear sunscreen every day. I'm not as good about sunscreen as I should be. This one by Dr. Jart is also so good. This is a light fluid. It literally feels like nothing on your skin. If you have dry skin, this is also a really good option. And that's all I do for my skincare routine. Pretty freaking easy. Still on the topic of skincare, as a holiday treat, I am gonna be giving away this whole box of skincare goodies that include some of my all-time favorites. Let me just show you guys what's inside. Just a little sneak peek. You guys see me talk about this guy all the time, the Dr. Dennis Gross peels. Big shout out to Dr. Dennis Gross for being nice enough to sponsor this giveaway with product. I wanted to be selfish and keep these for myself, but I'm gonna let you guys win the toner and the moisturizer also. I have the Sick Repair holiday set that has been sold out, but this includes the TikTok viral Sick Repair color correcting treatment, as well as some samples and a full size mask. I'm also gonna throw in some microneedling blemish patches. And then I have some goodies from Flamingo. With these two guys alone, I am just hooking it up. But on top of these two, you are getting so much more. All of these products deserve a fancy new home. If you want a chance to win this box of skincare goodies, then all you have to do is subscribe to this channel, follow me on Instagram, and comment on my latest Instagram post with a peace sign emoji. That way I know you're coming specifically from this video and I will reach out to you via DM. So you guys have 1 week to enter and I will be randomly choosing one winner. Good luck and happy holidays. So I desperately need to deep clean this apartment. It hasn't had a nice deep clean in a while. Just finished cleaning the entire apartment, so I'm finally gonna just chill out, lay in bed. I had 2 friends come over last night who are going through breakups, so kind of want to go through, you know, heartbreak and how to get over that. But before we get into that, I do want to shout out Audible for sponsoring this video. If you don't know what Audible is, they are the leading provider of spoken word entertainment, ranging from audiobooks, podcasts, meditation. There's something for everybody, and I just started listening to Dr. Brené Brown's The Power of Vulnerability. I discovered Dr. Brené Brown on the Red Table Talk not too long ago. I just fell in love with her and I fell in love with everything she had to say. And it's really just about how we as human beings fear vulnerability because it's associated with a lot of emotions that we want to avoid, such as fear itself. shame, uncertainty, but she really brings light to the fact that vulnerability is really the birthplace of where we develop deep, meaningful connection, we develop joy. It all starts at vulnerability. I'm probably gonna listen to it more later on when I'm like folding laundry or something. Audible members get 1 credit per month that can be used on any audiobook, and if you don't use the credit, you can roll it over to the next month. You can get a free 30-day trial through my link, audible.com/freesia, or you can text freesia to 500-500. I gotta make myself extra comfy. I went through my last breakup about a year ago. It was a little over a year ago. If I were to break it down into stages, the first stage is just allowing yourself to feel. And I think this is the part where a lot of people can go wrong. We as human beings want to avoid pain. We want to avoid anything that hurts us, anything that feels bad. We want to avoid it. Fresh out of a breakup, that feeling is just grief, it's loss. I always describe heartbreak as the worst form of pain. I would rather get physically beaten than go through heartbreak sometimes. When you're in it, it's devastating. It's the worst thing ever. You can't eat, you can't sleep. You know, you're just crying 24/7. That's the scariest thing and the most uncomfortable thing for people, is feeling that pain. And this stage one of allowing yourself to feel is where people start distracting themselves instead, through maybe substance abuse or jumping right into a new relationship or a rebound relationship, a sexual relationship. People are gonna do anything to forget about the pain and to numb it. And this hinders the healing process so much, because the pain is going to come up in one way or another. It's going to hit you no matter what. And when we distract ourselves by, you know, drinking excessively, smoking, hooking up with someone else, we are just delaying the time frame. So during stage one, you must allow yourself to feel, which means crying. You are totally entitled and okay to cry. It's healthy to cry and feel sad. Allow it to happen and just let it be. There's something really healing about letting the tears just flow. Stage two for me is becoming really bitter and angry. So that's after I've finished crying and have run out of tears. I start getting angry and I start pointing fingers at the other person, like, this person did me wrong, this person lied to me, this person could have done, you know, X, Y, and Z better, what is wrong with them, I hate them for this. And that's okay, you can feel angry, but just don't execute it to anyone in real life. But what I like to do is write things down in my journal, and I have pages and pages of breakup letters and notes to myself. In my last relationship, I actually wrote down like fill in the blank notes for myself. It said, I feel blank, and I just wrote every word that came to mind. There were words like, I feel pissed off. I feel angry that he didn't see the value in me. I feel betrayed, and just curse up a storm in those letters that you write. Say everything you can never say to a real person, because this is gonna be the most like relief you'll feel in a while. There's something about handwriting it out on paper. It just makes you feel so refreshed. Talk shit on paper, basically, and just go off. And then stage three for me is trying to reflect on myself now. This is where I stop pointing fingers at the other person and try to think about how I contributed to the failure of the relationship. Evaluate why I wasn't a good match for my ex and why my ex wasn't a good match for me. It's important to think about that too, because it's not just about you not meeting someone else's needs. That person didn't meet your needs also, so you have to think about why that is and what's important to you. Through this process of reflection, you have to really be honest with yourself, really be honest with your own shortcomings, because you have them for sure. You're not perfect. Figure out, okay, what are these issues? Where is this coming from? For example, in my last relationship, I realized that I wasn't communicative. And for the longest time, I would blame that on all of my exes, because this was an issue in all of my relationships. But I was always like, they just don't understand me. They don't get me. But then the last relationship kind of opened my eyes and helped me see that I'm the problem. I'm the one who doesn't know how to be vulnerable. I'm the one that doesn't know how to open up and be transparent when it's needed, because I'm just so guarded all the time. So really just thinking about that and figuring out how to work on it, how to fix it through acts of self-care and self-love is so much more important than distracting yourself and ignoring it. I do that in a lot of different ways. And in my breakup last year, I was actively going to the gym and working out to better myself mentally and physically, because I noticed that when I was working out, I had so much more clarity in the way that I thought and processed information. I was a lot more productive. I also read some self-help books, listened to a ton of podcasts. It's a process. You just have to constantly work on yourself. And then once you do that, things just start falling into place. You start realizing, wow, that person really just wasn't a good fit for me. And, you know, I'm okay with it now. I have more clarity as to who I am and what brings me joy. You have to work on yourself for kind of the fog to dissipate from the window of your inner self. It sounds cliche, you know, self-love, self-care, but it's something that people don't do often. So those are kind of my processes. But a few tips that also help along the way is to cut off your ex, okay? Too many people try to play the whole friend game, but I firmly do not believe in being friends with your ex. I think you can be cordial. So let's say you run into them in public, totally unplanned. Just be respectful. Be like, hey, hello, how are you? I'm good. Okay, great, done. You cannot create this open line of communication with your ex just so that it's easier for them to get over you. Keeping in touch with your ex is just, it's a validation game, because wanting to be friends just really means, oh, like if I'm ever really sad or depressed, or if I ever like feel unsure about myself, I want to be able to reach out to you and say I miss you. I want to be able to check in on you and know that you are still around for when I need it. You just need to cut off all lines of communication until you have completed your healing process, aka these stages. Once you've completed the healing process and you are completely over them, fine, check in, catch up, do what you gotta do. But during the healing process, you should not be talking to your ex. Tip two, if you know you are a drunk texter, delete their number. I have never run into this. I never call or text anybody when I'm drunk, but I know hella people do. So if you are that person, delete the number so that you avoid. Just, this is a mess of a situation, just avoid it. Oh, another thing is every time I break up with someone, I immediately unfollow them on social media. It's not out of spite, it's not out of anger, but it's just that I know I will have a hard time getting over the relationship if I'm constantly reminded of them on my Instagram feed, on my Instagram stories, and it really does help me. Just remove all ties. There's no point in looking at what they're doing in their day-to-day if it doesn't help you move on. That's kind of my process on how to mend a broken heart. If you're going through a breakup or thinking about breaking up with someone, trust me, I feel you. I feel you so much. But as much as you don't want to hear this, there is light at the end of the tunnel and you will get over it. It's just a matter of time. Just keep reminding yourself of that and you're gonna come out smarter and stronger.